Sunday for us, and that's always exciting. We get to do our mission update. We'll tell you more about that in just a moment. And the powers that be, those above us, meaning the people in the loft, have told me that you are having some technical difficulties, so if we hear popping and stuff like that, don't run out till you hear the alarms, and then need to leave the building. I'm just kidding on that part, okay? So we may hear some turning on and off and stuff like that, but it just be, for those of you who come on a regular basis, it's another Sunday for us here, and that's okay. We're going to get right through it. We're going to be fine. So now it's good to have everybody. Again, let me remind you, today we're going to have our mission update. So in a little while, you're going to hear from our youth camp. You're going to hear from our children's activities this summer, VBS and children's camp. You're going to hopefully see videos on those. We'll see how that goes. And here's some reports on that, some other stuff that we did throughout the summer. And also, hopefully, here's some new things coming up, and we do have some voting we're going to do today. So for those of you who are guests, let me tell you what we're doing. Mission update is basically our business meeting. Now, we covered a lot of the business a couple of weeks ago, so we won't have to do our budget and cover things like that. But I wanted you guys to see what we kind of do and hope to do during a regular business meeting, which we no longer call business meeting. We call it mission update now because the church has been sent on a mission. This church and every church as the body of Christ is on a mission. And therefore, we need to have an update of how that mission is going, where we're at, what we still need to do, and how we need to continue on in that. So today, I hope you get to experience that. So, but before we do that, we definitely want to have a time of worship. So, stand up with me. We're going to share our verse of proclamation, and this is just one of God's truth that we need to know. And after this, we're going to have our time of prayer. And so, say this verse out loud with me. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not your own doing. It is the gift of God, not a result of works, so that no one may boast. Ephesians 2, 8, and 9. Now listen, you've got a few more weeks on this verse, and then we'll get another verse going. Who remembers the verse we had before this? Anybody? I heard one. Galatians? Any more than that? We're doing so well up here. Yes. Galatians 2:20. All right, we had Galatians 2:20. There's no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. This life I live in the flesh, I no longer live. So, okay, sounds familiar at all to you? I hope it does. But continue to learn these. This is Bible scripture memorization. You will not always have your Bible handy. You will not always have your pastor handy to tell you what that said. So you need to know God's word in your heart. David in the Psalms wrote, I hide God's word in my heart that I may not what? Sin against him. Okay? That's going to keep you from that. Remember, either the Bible keeps you from sin or sin keeps you from the Bible. So start to memorize these things. Start to learn them. Feel free to write them down and go back and see them again. Okay? We'll get some more going. Now, our prayer focus this morning on lostness. We want to see God change things. And we want to see things change. And I forget to change that thing, so we're going to focus on lostness. But we're also focusing on not just the lostness in the country or in the world, but also our part as the body of Christ in that lostness. Because we can step back and just say, y'all need to do something different. And it's true, but the truth is, God says, what are you doing differently? What are you doing to be a part of that kingdom work to change this world? I've already sent my Son, I've sent my Holy Spirit, and I've sent you. It's your faithfulness that makes a part of that plan. So pray with me as we go into prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you again for your love and your grace, Father, most of all for dying for us at the cross of Calvary to give us true eternal life. And Father, I do want to lift up this lostness as we look at this world around us. But Father, I pray for those of us who call ourselves believers that we would have a burden. Father, we would have a burden to see that change. Father, we would have a burden to have light come into this world as a whole, just like it came into us personally. And Father, I pray that we know that we are called to be a part of that mission. And Father, as we go on into this part of our worship service in a little bit for our mission update, I pray, Father, we're encouraged. I pray we're challenged. And Father, I pray that we're open to something new that you're going to call us to. Father, thank you for the people that you use in this. Father, thank you for the ways you use this church. Father, thank you for the offering that we're about to give. Thank you, Father, for every cent that is given. Father, and we pray that everything that is given to your glory, to your honor, that you would use it continually as you have been through us to reach this entire planet. Thank you again, Lord, for your love and your grace, for dying for us at the cross of Calvary. It's in your name we pray, Lord. Amen.
Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ. Worship with us. They're going to pass around the offering. Shake someone's hand. Hug someone's neck. Tell them you're glad to see them this morning.
I worship you. opportunity that we have to give glory, honor to your name, God. I pray that you would be with those who needed to receive this worship this morning, God. Prepare our hearts for Pastor Jason as he brings the word. And we look forward to hearing how camp went for the kids this summer as well, God. We ask your blessing upon today in your name.
Children are not dismissed to children's church yet, so if your child left, you don't need to know where they went. I see people leaving to go get a pumpkin. So today we're going to do something a lot different. We're having our mission update. And let me explain again. We have business meetings. We've always had them because anytime you have an organization, you need to have structure with it. You need to know where things are going. But the problem with business meeting, for years we've called them that forever, and a lot of people don't show up because, well, I don't really care. Nobody wants to say that out loud, but you always have something that's more pressing, something's more important, and it's not like you think about it all that time. So I changed the name to Mission Update because I want to recast this vision of what it is that we are doing here. We are a church. We are the body of Christ. We are an organization. We are also a spiritual organism that God uses, and he works through this. And let me give you two pieces of scripture. When the Israelites were called out of Egypt, they were into the desert, wandering around for 40 years, because even back then, a man wouldn't stop and ask for directions. So that's not the whole problem, but that was part of it, I think. So as they're going, God is preparing them to be this people. He said, you're going to be my people, and I want you to know how to live. And this is what he tells them in Exodus 19, starting with verse 5. Now therefore, if you will indeed obey my voice and keep my covenant, you shall be my treasured possession among all peoples, for all the earth is mine. And you shall be to me a kingdom of priests and a holy nation. These are the words that you shall speak to the people of Israel. And he's telling Moses, tell them you're going to be a priest, a nation of priests. Priests are the ones who taught them the God's word, taught them what it was to worship God, and led them in that. And they were those who taught the others how to live like the people of God. And he said, Israel, you are going to be a whole nation of priests, all of you. Well, that sounds good for them, but how about the rest of us now that we're in the New Testament church? Well, Paul left us with this. Ephesians chapter 3, starting in verse 8. He said, to me, though I am the very least of all the saints, this grace was given to me. And anytime Paul said this grace given to me, that means his ministry. That's how he referred to it. To preach to the Gentiles the unsearchable riches of Christ, and to bring to light for everyone what is the plan of the mystery hidden for ages in God who created all things, so that through the church the manifold wisdom of God might now be made known to the rulers and authorities in heavenly places. And some of your Bibles, if you read that, it say the manifestation or the manifest of the church. In other words, as the body of Christ, now we are left here to be this manifestation and to manifold these truths of God out in front of the world so that we can bring light into these dark places. And that's what we're called to do as the body. So as we see these things going on, as we talk about this stuff going on, it's more than just scriptures and sermons and singing and some classes here and there. It's about becoming the people of God. And that involves everyone out here, whether you're here now or if you're watching later online. It doesn't matter. That includes you, especially if you call yourself a believer. You should belong to some church somewhere. So as we go into this time of mission update, and you get to hear about the things that we've done throughout the summer, some great reports I can only tell you ahead of time, don't want to be a spoiler alert, there's a lot of great things. And we have some other business to handle at the end of this. We won't go all day, so you can bring a lunch, that's okay. But we do have some things that we want to cover. I want you to hear what God is doing. So I want to turn it over to our moderator. Our moderator for our church is always the chairman of the deacons, and that now is Brother Scott Montgomery, so I'm going to turn it over to him.
I was told to wear this shirt.
Preach it, brother.
All right. So to open our, it's customary we open our business meeting in a prayer. So Brother Dan Hansen, would you open us in prayer?
Heavenly Father, Lord, we open up in time of business and looking at mission, just looking at how you've used in our church, Lord, and here and abroad, Lord, we just pray your blessing upon this time, Lord. We just pray that, Lord, we'll see how your hands are moving, Lord, but also be encouraged, Lord, to do more when you call on us too. So we just pray you'll put a blessing around this place and that we hear your words. In Christ's name, amen. Amen.
So first on our mission update will be a report from the children.
Obviously, I'm the children. The children are always super busy in the summer. So the children's ministry here at the church, we have two main things that we do in the summer. Teen Kid always ends in May. And then we do two main activities in the summer, and then we start Teen Kid back up in the fall. So I want to go ahead and just throw out some things that we will be doing in the fall. It's just two that I wanted to throw out there for parents to know about. Our Teen Kid Wednesday night, and along with youth, Teen Kid is for children in pre-K to fifth grade. If they are in sixth and up, they go to youth. Okay, Teen Kid's on this side, youth is on that side. And Teen Kid, I tell the kids, it's like a longer VBS because basically we do kind of the same things that we do in VBS. It just takes a little bit, you know, we have a little bit longer time on each one. That'll start September the 6th, and it's from 5:30 to 7:30. We open the doors at 5:15. I just say that because we do have kids that are dropped off like at 5 o'clock and it's super hot. And we, the teachers, need a little bit of time to get their stuff prepared, so we open the doors at 5:15. Also, if your child is in WOW or your child would like to be in WOW, WOW is the Children's Ministry Ways of Worship. It was started by Twyla, and I've taken over doing it since I've been the children's minister, and we meet at 4:30. I do know that school does not get out till 4, but that's the only time we have. So we meet WOW at 4:30. We do skits, we do music, we do sign language. We'll be working on the children's Christmas play. So it's from 4:30, and then we go right into Teen Kid at 5:15. So if your child comes and they go to Teen Kid, they can just stay with me the whole time. In October the 17th, we will be starting the new Christian class. We've got quite a few already lined up and signed up wanting to come to that. This year, we're going to try to do it from 5:30 to 6:30. I will let you know, time may change. It depends on some people's schedules, but I'm trying to do that so that the people from out of town, we have some from Whitney, some from Aquila, some from Marble, you know, different places that want to come, want to bring their children to that. And I wanted to give them a chance to get out of school, get a snack, and then they can get their kids here, do homework, whatever they needed to do. So right now I've got it scheduled October 17th from 5:30 to 6:30, but the time may change. So I just wanted to let everybody know those are our upcoming activities. Now I'll just kind of go back over some of our stuff for summer. Is VBS okay for the first one? Okay. All right. So in July, we try to have our VBS, Vacation Bible School. The first week of July. Well, this year it was kind of weird because the 4th of July kind of messed us up on that, but we still were able to do a 3-day Bible school. So instead of doing a crazy curriculum and trying to shove it all in, we did something called Journey to the Cross. So it's a little different. We had people, they didn't want me to call them this, but we called them actors, and we acted out the Journey to the Cross in 3 days. And so I want to thank everybody that did that. We're going to see in a minute, you're going to see the video. I put use the music God's Not Dead because that was our purpose, okay? That wasn't our theme song, but it was our purpose to make sure the kids understood that. And we had a lot of fun. Our average attendance was around 40. Between that and our church camp, I think we have like 3 to 4 kids that are awaiting baptism, I think. We're still working with some parents on that, but it was really successful and a lot of fun. So a lot of us got to wear costumes, and we had our food and our crafts, and missions was great. We had a lot of fun those 3 days. So we've got this video to show you about that. So can somebody grab the lights in the back, Matt? my first attempt, so there you go. Francis is just back there laughing. Okay. But anyway, Francis has always helped us out with that, and her kids are too old now, so I'm kind of doing it. But yeah, y'all saw how crazy that was. So I asked the kids today, just I was asking a few of them what was their favorite scene for, of VBS. I got a lot of food answers. I got a lot of food answers, so Deborah, wherever you're at, they love that. I did get a couple that said the booth, which I'm assuming means the marketplace, but that also had to do with food, some of it. So anyway, it was bread booth and the food booth. James told me everything. He couldn't pick a favorite, so I thought that was pretty good. Atlin said the dark sin room, so y'all saw that. We talked about our sin and why Jesus had to come. And then I had several of them said dog ball and kickball, so red was a big hit. I did have one say the crafts, Miss Buddy, but she also said the crafts that we got to eat. So there you go with the food. But anyway, I do want to thank everybody. We really, like I said, we really had a fun time. It was a lot of fun. Even some of the marketplace ladies that, you know, didn't have to come back the next day, they came every single day dressed up. We just had a blast. So, like I said, in all, our whole purpose was to let the kids know that God's not dead, that he loves them, and that he, you know, that we want to glorify him. So, the next thing I want to talk about, the other thing that we do that's really big is church camp. This year, I got special permission. Usually it's third grade completed to sixth grade completed. The sixth graders are kind of, I don't know what to call them, the lost children, because they don't get to go to youth camp. Youth camp doesn't accept sixth graders. So we have included them with preteen camp. So they're kind of our leaders. They're the ones that all the other kids look up to, mostly because they've been there and they know where everything's at, and you know, they know how to get away with things, they know, you know where to hide, all of that good stuff. But anyway, just joking. But this year we got permission, and so I was allowed to bring the second graders that had finished. I don't know if that will be okay next year, but we did get permission to do that. So we have some kids that are going into third grade up to sixth graders. There's lots of different things. I am so sorry. I'm going to let you know this is a 10-minute video because it was so hard. I see what Francis had to deal with. It is so hard to pick out pictures because you go, oh, that was cute. Oh, that was awesome. Ooh, that's got a lot of kids in it. Ooh, you know. And so I want y'all to get the full picture because the church does support us. I wanted to thank the Irvine Christian Foundation. They support us through a grant that I write for every year. The Shepherd Foundation, they support us, help us, because it takes a lot to take 40-something people to camp. And then the church also sets money aside in the budget for us to use for camp also. And Jason and I share that, all of those three things, when he takes the youth to camp. So anyway, I just wanted to let you know, I will tell you that I asked favorites for this too, and Wet Willie was one. In a little bit, you're gonna see a giant slide. You climb this tower and it's a giant sluice looking slide. That is the Wet Willie. Izzy said the chicken fried steak was her favorite. Atlin said breakfast. Kinley just said the food in general. She was all about that. Remy, Jake said the afternoon concession stand. And thank goodness, Kylan said something different, but I'm afraid it was the lake. So, but we do have Bible study, and we do have other things that go on during church camp, but you can see where the kids' focus is food. I also would like you, if you went to camp as a sponsor or student, raise your hand, because we've got quite a few of you here today. Now, if you were a sponsor, please stand up, please. Nathan, you too. People, it was 110 like every day. So, and let me tell you, the attitudes of our sponsors, they were amazing. They were so happy, so upbeat, so cheerful. It was just wonderful because I was so dead by the end, but they were still going and everything was wonderful, and the kids had a blast this year. Our theme, if you can't tell, was glow. So we've got a lot of glow-in-the-dark pictures that are going to go with this. I hope they came through. So anyway, I'm just going to go ahead and stop and let y'all enjoy the video.
Push on through. After all, it's the least that you can do. But don't buy one this.
At the Southern Baptist Convention, we also help make those decisions. The Southern Baptist Convention, we are autonomous, which means we are completely independent of other churches. Nobody tells me what to preach, except for some of you guys. You have suggestions, and that's fair. But nobody checks on us. Nobody else owns this property but us. Okay, so we are completely autonomous. Although we come together in a partnership known as the Southern Baptist Convention, and we work with each other in order to share the gospel all over the planet. And I will tell you, we are doing that in countries you probably haven't even heard of, a lot of that you have. And so it's great to get to meet missionaries and things like that. I do not have any pictures because most of them involve beignets, and I didn't want to do that to you guys. But we did have the Southern Baptist Convention summer. There's always some kind of controversy every year just because we like to keep life interesting. This year, we had some churches that we disfellowshipped. And basically, disfellowship means that we say, praise God for you, but don't send your money anymore. This is a partnership, and we won't be partnered with you. We don't make them change who they are. We don't make them do anything different. We just say that the agreed upon doctrines that we have, you're not keeping up with, or we see them differently, so and that's fine. So you go do your thing, and we'll do ours. And that always happens. Again, no ill will towards anyone. We just say this is what we agreed upon ahead. And that did happen with three particular churches, one of which was Saddleback Church out of California, Rick Warren's church. So if you want to know more about that, we can talk about it later. So I'm going to go move on to the youth stuff. I was the interim youth minister. My apologies for that to all the youth. This past year, we had a good year. We always graduate out some, and so they meet each Wednesday. And the first semester, I gave them the challenge that if they brought their Bible, I would give them either a Coke or a Dr. Pepper, whichever one they want. Anybody care to guess which ones they took most of? Dr. Pepper was always number one, yes. So I always have this, I have extras. But the next semester, I said, well, that's great. You guys did really well bringing your Bibles. And no, I would not count the apps on their phone because I never saw them open those until I said, I'll give you something to drink for it. Food does go a long way with these guys. It really does. So the next semester, though, I said, we got to up the ante a little bit now. So you guys have to bring me a Bible verse that you have memorized. You can only use the verse once, but other people can all use that same verse. It doesn't matter, and we keep a chart, and I meant to bring the chart in here, but my old age is getting ahead of me, and I forgot to bring it up, and I'll have it hanging in the fellowship hall if you want to see who did it. I think Caleb probably did the most. Caleb, was it you and Cassidy? Was that right? I think it was probably you and Cassidy were kind of in a race for the most. They did really well with that. They had a ton of them. A lot of students were doing it. What was really cool was some students, honestly, you can tell their Bible knowledge because they're going to somebody else going, give me a verse. I don't know where any of these verses are. And I'm like, it's open book test. It's right in front of you, okay? So you can look at it and come and tell me it's fine. But it was good to see their friends helping them learn verses even just for the second so they can go get a drink. But we got to see some of that happen. End of the summer, end of the year, we take off the summer just like the preteens do and the children for Teen Kid. So, but the end of ours is Super Summer. Super Summer is a camp. It's completed seventh through completed 12th grade. And we have different ones we go to. We go to Dallas Baptist. It's closest. It's good facilities. We like it. Our kids love it. The food is good. So all the things that they are looking for. Super Summer is a little different camp. It's not intended to be a camp where they present gospel to everyone. The idea is that in Super Summer, they want you to know and share the gospel. So they want to go and teach students how to do that, okay, how to live that out. This year was extremely good in teaching that. We had a speaker named Shannon Hopkins, and he is a missionary from Honduras. He did a great job. The first day there, he said, listen, I need 5 volunteers. And everybody looked at him and goes, don't ask what it's for. I just need 5 volunteers. And of course, teenagers, by the way, parents, at home, you ask them to do something, they just look at you like you just grew a second head somewhere. What? Do something. There, it's ooh, 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 ooh. Everybody wanted to volunteer. So he got 5 students and he said, meet me for dinner this evening. So that evening, they all got to dinner and he had those 5 students there. And he said, okay, so tell me your testimony. Tell me your walk of faith. You know, you got to know them at first, you know, where you're from, what's your name, where you go to school, what grade you're in, that kind of thing. And then they shared their faith. And he said, that was awesome. He said, now, each of you have to find 5 people to do that with tomorrow. He And then those five went to another five, another five. By the end of the week, he got them all in there. He said, where are my five students, my first five? And they stood up. He said, that is awesome. Thank you guys for coming. He said, by the way, if someone asked you to sit with them at lunch or dinner or sometime, would you please stand up? 95% of the camp stood up. There's over 500 students there. And he said, you guys did that in about 3 days, because that's about all the time they had. And I noticed that not all the students stood up, which is common, that's life. And he said, by the way, look around at these students sitting here, that's how the lost feel, left out. But he taught them what multiplication looks like. And he challenged them with that. And I got invited to sit at somebody's table, and I went, and they did say, hey, so where are you guys from, what grade are you in, that kind of stuff. So tell me your faith, tell me about your walk of faith and stuff like that, just a couple of minutes. You know, and so it was great. It was great to see these students actually step out and learn what ministry is. He did a great job with it. So I asked Francis to take this video, and I don't have my clicker with me. But if you notice, there's different color schools. Oh, go back just a second. There we go. Different color schools. Every school, you're in a school in Super Summer, according to your grade. Okay, everybody in that school is in the same grade. So you go down, your first year is red school, and then you go to blue school if you're going into the ninth grade, and then you go to orange school, which is up there, it is orange school, then you go to yellow school, then you go to green school, and then right in the middle you go to khaki school. I know it doesn't look khaki because years ago someone said, this is boring, let's all wear pink to go with it. And I have no doubt it was some girls and boys who liked them. So now the tradition is you wear khaki and pink if you're in khaki school. Now Dallas Baptist has a unique one when they have it there. It's called purple school. And that is for students who are going to be juniors or seniors or just graduated who feel called to the ministry. And they had that there. I was in khaki school this year, and I did not wear my pink. Yellow school, I've done green school and blue school. I've done a lot of those. So do we have this video now? Okay, so I'll let you see this video and we'll talk some more about that.
The old is on the way, the old is on the way. This is
Yes, that hurt afterwards. Couldn't let those kids go. If you see lots of activity in Super Summer, we want kids there, and they start. One reason why I like this camp is because students start to take initiative in their own lives. You don't stay in a regular dorm like you do at a preteen camp, you know, where you have everybody in there. Basically, two or three students to the dorm. Is that right, GW? Am I telling that right? How many did you guys have?
We had three.
You had three in yours, yeah. I think some of the rain, you had two in yours, yeah. Rain's been the guys. By the way, we took, normally in the last few years I've gone, we've taken three students each time. So I've taken my minivan, not a big deal. This year we had 10 that we took. And I'm sorry, we ended up with 9. One had to drop out at the last second. We took 9. And Mandy Moore, who wasn't here, was also our chaperone. She did a great job. Loved having her there. Such a servant heart for that. She was in yellow school. But anyhow, you have your own dorm room. You and your roommates stay in there. No adults in there, although we have adults on the floor. And we have check-ins in the night and things like that. So make sure everybody gets there. And dorm captains and things like that. But these students are on their own for the most part. They learn how to get to where they need to be. And we have people checking to make sure they made it. But this is when they start to grow. And you are, I've got to tell you, parents, it's amazing to watch your students worship when they're not with you. They really do just cut loose, and you see all the hands raising, and you see kids on their knees, and it looks like they're just going crazy because you saw a lot of wreck pictures and stuff like that, and they do go crazy at wreck, and we have some injuries because that's why we sign releases ahead of time. It's just part of it, right? But they have a lot of fun, but they really do grow spiritually. It's amazing how much they do, and to see that. And we even have a talk with them because we've learned this is sponsors and stuff that you guys will shower this week, you will use deodorant, stuff like that. It's usually the younger ones, the older ones, the girls will tell that, they'll learn quickly. But we had a great time. And you know, we have these guys who learn and they grow and they're challenged to grow in their faith, and we love it. So that was our Super Summer for that. So I think for now we're gonna move into our next part for that. Thank you guys, by the way, for praying for us and sponsoring students and helping them out for that as well. So I'm going to give it back to Mr. Scott. You want me to explain this first? The voting? Okay. We're going to pass out ballots here in just a second. You're getting these. We're going to have two votes here in just a minute, part of our new business, because we have old business, catch up on stuff, and new business, and stuff's coming new. The first one we're going to vote on is for the church clerk. Okay, that's the person who takes notes. That's the person who just kind of signs their name to some stuff like that. When I go to Southern Baptist Convention, the church clerk has to sign off that the church did vote to send me or whoever else as a messenger. By the way, anybody in here can go as a messenger as long as you're a member of the church and we vote on you. We've had other people do it. Next year is in Indianapolis, and some other years come up are going to be Orlando, and yes, everyone goes there for vacation before or after, and also Dallas. So if you ever want to think about it, it's a great time.